Konnichiwa. Today's daily devotional is for Monday, February the 17th, 2020, but it's from October the 21st, 2019, when I shared with my coworkers only, okay? Before I went on the internet and social media. And it's called Natural Born Leaders. And I'm going to start with Proverbs 27, 23 through 24. Be sure you know the condition of your flocks. Give careful attention to your herds. For riches do not endure forever, and a crown is not secure for all generations. All right, the week before that I posted this, I saw on IG a clip posted by @men_and_baby. From the view of a high-rise skyscraper apartment. And inside there was a baby and a cat, a black cat, and the baby's mom. So the baby was probably no more than 10 months to 1 year old, okay? And he could walk around, like stand up and hold onto the window. Okay, so on the outside, the other side of the glass, the window, were two window washers, okay? You know, they wear their harness and they're high up in the air. And it appeared that one of the window washers was training the other one, okay? And so the man that was doing the washing of the window was entertaining the baby and keeping his eye on the baby the entire time, but he was playing with the cat with his window washer and the soap, the suds. So every time he would wipe the window, and the soap would be all bubbly, and the cat would chase the scraper, and the baby would be cracking up laughing with the most adorable laugh ever. So the entire time, the man's coworker that he was training and the baby's mom was watching him interact with the baby and the cat. Okay, but the whole time, like I said, the man never took his eyes off the baby. So I'm sure he was aware they were watching because he was smiling and laughing right along with them. Okay, and his coworker was amazed at how great this guy was because he was really flipping fantastic. I'm telling you, I was cracking up the entire time too, you know? So this shows him how he needs to interact with his customer as well as do his job well, okay? So, and also the man was making funny faces at the baby, like, ooh, like, you know, and it was just really, really cute. So I just really love it. Okay, so like I said, I'm sure the man was aware they were watching, but he was focused more on the thing that mattered the most to him at that moment, the baby and the cat. Even though the man was in a high up and dangerous position, and he was getting very well paid for, I'm pretty sure. I feel like the most rewarding part of his day was knowing he made the people that looked up and out to him very happy. Beautiful story. You guys should look it up, okay? That brings me to 1 Timothy 4:12. Don't let anyone look down on you because you are young. But set an example for the believers in speech, in conduct, in love, in faith, and in purity. Okay, there are two young leaders at my job that I work at, and they are just like that window washer, all right? One of them is a director, and she sits right behind me, and she refuses to sit in a director's seat, okay? Because she wants to sit amongst the little people, okay? Like me, all right? So she's very busy, and people think she's grumpy, but, you know, she's not. She's just the sweetest thing ever, and she has the biggest heart. Okay, she knows I'm just like that cat and I always like to play and cut jokes very early in the morning. I'm an early bird. So, and she comes in and I'm just sitting there waiting on her, like when she gets in, okay? All right, so when she gets there, she makes time for my foolishness, okay? And everyone around us, including our VP and the COO, they're just waiting because they know that we're gonna entertain them. They're listening, and before you know it, we're all laughing. We're all laughing, okay? And I will never cross the line with her though, because I understand she's very busy, and you know, and I like the fact that she never looks down on me, okay? So I have a lot of respect for her. All right. Okay, so the other leader is the same with his people, pretty much, you know. He's a real stand-up kind of guy, you know. He doesn't know, but I've watched him from afar, like plenty of times, you know, because I'm amazed with and I have a lot of respect for him, okay, because he never looks down on his team, and then he engages with them in a professional way, and he gives them constructive criticism when needed, okay? And also, unbeknownst to him, a while back, one of his employees was gonna quit because she was very discouraged, and it was hard for her to get the work. And I told her, I said, no, don't give up. Just keep, you know, going at it. You're doing a great job. So I started praying for her, like, every day, like, really putting my heart into it. And then I swear, within a week or so, he started sitting with her, like, patiently over and over again, explaining the work with her, like, for a long hours at a time. Like, it really is amazing. And not once did I ever see him get frustrated. You couldn't see it on his face. You know, he probably did, but you never saw it, you know? Okay, so I don't know very many bosses that'll do that, people. They'll tell you, you better get it together, I'm gonna replace you. Or they'll just replace you without letting you know. Okay, so kudos to him, all right? That brings me to James 3:1. Not many of you should become teachers, my fellow believers, because you know that we who teach will be judged more strictly. Okay, these people are unnatural. All right. And you never know who's watching. I was watching. So, but I'm not that important, but other people will be looking at them. Okay. And it really means a lot to the little people who spend most of their day of, you know, hours of the day in the workforce, you know, in the office, away from their families, to have a leader show that they care. Okay. And that brings me to Proverbs 23:29. Seest thou a man diligent in his business? He shall stand before kings. He shall not stand before mean men. Okay, I know that those two will go even further in their careers. Okay, and one of them has since I wrote this. Okay, he got a promotion, and I'm really happy for him. Okay, and I know that it has a lot to do with their mentorship, because I've also witnessed a few of their people move up. Okay, and the way they work with their new team is, it almost exactly mirrors the way their leader, this guy and this girl, has trained them, okay? Does that make sense to you guys? I hope so, okay? So that's an admirable trait to have, and they deserve that position they're in, okay? Because not everyone that is a leader was called by God to be a leader, all right? Power thought. I've learned that people will forget what you said, people will forget what you did, but people will never forget how you made them feel. Miss Maya Angelou. Love you guys. Have a great day. Mwah.